boys and girls, how are you this morning? Are you well? I'd like to tell you a story, but first I need to ask you some questions. Have you ever had something that you really, really liked and you had looked for it and longed for it for a long time? How did it feel? Were you happy that you finally got it? And how would you have felt if you lost it again? You would be sad, wouldn't you? Now, I'm going to tell you a story of a little boy who longed for something and then he finally got it and he lost it. But he remembered that Jesus said that he will answer all our prayers. So let's listen to the story as I read it and let us remember that God always answers our prayers. Are you ready for the story? Harry's motorboat. The great dream of his life had come true. For years and years, so it seemed, Harry had longed for a real motorboat, one that would go all by itself without having to be wound up. And now at last it had come. Only this very morning his uncle had brought him one as a birthday present. What happiness! First of all, of course, it had to be tried in the bath, just to see if it would really go. But after Harry had seen it get up steam and go up and down the bath for a score of times, he could not rest until he had taken it to the lake. So, taking along a bottle of methylated spirits, a box of matches and his precious boat, he started off. You will be careful, won't you? Said Mother. Of course, promised Harry. And be sure to be back by 6 o'clock. Yes, Mother. And away he went. What fun he did have. What a joy it was to watch the little engine getting up steam until at last, amid much fizzing and spluttering, the piston gave its first jerk and the propeller began to spin. Away went the little boat across the lake, while Harry rushed round in his bare feet to meet it at the other side. So excited was he that he walked into the water to meet it coming in. Turning it around, he sent it off again, this time towards a different spot. He was surprised how far the boat would go with one filling up, and every time it came to land, he tried to make it go still further. Time goes quickly when one is happy, and Harry didn't notice how the hours were slipping by. At last, however, lengthening shadows roused him, and he stopped a passerby to ask him the time. 5:30. Phew, whistled Harry. I'll have to be packing up soon, but just one more trip. But how often it happens that the one more is really one too many. Anyway, it happened with poor Harry. For the last trip, he decided to send the boat the longest possible journey. If it reached the point aimed at, he thought, it would be quite near to the footpath that led toward home. So, he argued, it would really save time if he made the last trip the longest. Steam up once more, away went the motorboat on her transatlantic crossing, with Harry's delighted eyes following her every inch of the way. She's halfway across, he muttered to himself. Then his heart seemed to stand still. The motorboat had stopped. He felt sure it had stopped. There was no sign of movement, although he thought he could see steam coming out of the safety valve. Yes, it had really stopped. What happened, he couldn't tell. Perhaps he had used the boat too much for one afternoon. Perhaps it needed oil. Perhaps, dreadful thought, it had caught in some reeds. Poor Harry didn't know. He stood there on the bank with eyes glued on the boat, hoping against hope that it would start again. But it didn't move. that it had caught on something, he became convinced. How could he get it back? Far in the distance, he heard a factory whistle. That's the 5 to 6 whistle, he said to himself, and I must be home at 6. Poor Harry, what should he do? He must keep his promise to his mother, for he always did. But if he went away, someone would be sure to get the boat before he could return. In desperation, he walked into the water as far as he dared go, but he found that it suddenly became very deep, just a few yards from the shore, and he had to return. Again he looked at the little boat, quietly bobbing up and down in the middle of the lake. Then he thought of the time. Oh, what shall I do? He said to himself. There was no one about to whom he could turn for help, for the few who had been there in the afternoon had already gone home. Of a sudden, an unusual thought came to his mind. Some of you may smile when I tell you what it was. It was the music of a hymn he had sung in church a few days before. Presently the words came back to him. What a friend we have in Jesus, all our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. But, Harry said to himself, surely Jesus isn't interested in my little motorboat. He almost smiled at the thought. Then in his desperate anxiety he said, why not? Perhaps he is. And right there by the lakeside, Harry shut his eyes for just a second and asked Jesus to look after his little boat while he ran home to keep his promise to his mother. Taking one last loving look at his precious boat, he turned away and ran home as fast as he could. He was a few minutes late, but Mother said nothing about it, for she saw at once that he was greatly distressed. When she learned that he had even left his boat behind in the lake in order to keep his promise to her, she felt very proud of him indeed. After supper, she said, we will both go back, even though it is dark, to see what we can do with a ball of string. Supper didn't take long, I can assure you, and by 7:30, Harry and his mother were on their way back to the lake, with a flashlight and string enough to stretch across. By the time they arrived, a pale moon was rising, casting its rays across the silent waters. Eagerly they both strained their eyes, hoping to catch a glimpse of that little boat. It was over there, said Harry, right in the middle. I can't see it, said Mother. Neither can I, said Harry, with a trace of fear in his voice. Perhaps when the moon gets up a bit, began Mother with a note of encouragement. No, said Harry disconsolately, it's gone. I know just where it was. It must have sunk. They walked all around the lake, hoping perchance it might have drifted ashore, but nowhere was there a trace of it. There's no use looking anymore, sighed Harry. Let's go home. And in his heart he said, and what was the good of asking Jesus to look after it? Crunch! Heavy footsteps nearly startled them both. Hello, called a deep voice. What are you doing here in the dark? It was the game warden. I lost my motorboat this afternoon, said Harry, and Mother and I have come down to look for it. Have you found it? Asked the man more kindly. No, we haven't, said Harry. Shouldn't think you had, he said, in the dark. It's late now. You'd better follow me. Something strange in his tone of voice, raised Harry's hopes. They turned and followed the man along the lake shore. Presently they reached an old boathouse. The game warden stopped, pulled out a bunch of keys, and opened the door. Bring your flashlight over here, he said. As Mother held it, the beam fell on the precious motorboat. There it is! There it is! Cried Harry. How did you get it out of the lake? With my boat, said the game warden. I saw it caught in the reeds and guessed some boy would be looking for it. So I just rode out and brought it in. Thank you ever so much, said Harry, as he and mother said good night to the game warden. Then they hurried homeward, Harry gripping the motorboat as though there were danger of him losing it again. And on the way, his heart sent up a silent thanksgiving to the friend who never forgets a request and who even answers the prayer of a boy for his boat. That's a lovely story, isn't it, boys and girls? And you know, the best part of that story is that Jesus is interested in everything about us. He's not only interested in the big things, he's even interested in the small things, like toys that we have and we lost. Everything, it doesn't matter what the problem is, we can talk to Jesus. And we can tell him everything, and he will always answer. That is such a wonderful promise, that when we ask anything, God will answer us. I want you to remember that as you go through the new week. And remember also that Jesus is always there for us. Let's pray. Dear Jesus, thank you that you have promised to always answer our prayers. Thank you that you are interested in the big things and the small things in our lives, and that you are always there for us. In your name, amen.